Hi, I'm Chris Surridge, and I'm an educator at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology in Daejeon, South Korea, and I'm quite excited to be able to introduce this innovative new program called Devil Island Mystery. Devil Island Mystery combines the compelling immersive world of Second Life with the Moodle learning management system using tools created by the Sloodle Project. The result is a 10-mission, story-based adventure and learning interaction that has been shown to increase motivation, interest, and confidence in university-level English language students. To create interest and to add meaning to in-world interactions, a story was devised and captured in a sequence of videos filmed in Second Life. The story places the students in the center of the action. On their way to a tropical destination, their aircraft encounters mechanical trouble and crashes on Devil Island. While exploring the island, they find an interesting laboratory in the old lighthouse. They discover the existence of Vesuvius Mo, a famous explorer and scientist who was wrecked on Devil Island 20 years before. Having read some of Dr. Mo's journals and watched his documentary and movie clips, they learn that Dr. Mo had discovered a mysterious energy source that allowed him to escape Devil Island. Throughout the following missions, the students need to follow clues and reproduce Dr. Mo's research results in order to make their escape from Devil Island. Their early missions show them how to create their avatar in Second Life, register their avatar using the Sloodle tools, and learn how to take photographs in Second Life, as well as to blog from Second Life to their Moodle account. In later missions, they must work alone and with team members to complete actions which are consistent with the story. In Mission 4, they meet their team members on Devil Island and coordinate their search of the island. In Mission 5, they must explore the island in search of the 6 missing pages from Dr. Mo's journal. The journal pages hold critical information about the rest of the missions. Dr. Mo's journal pages tell of some mysterious energy-creating plants. In Mission 6, the students need to cooperate to reconstruct a broken map. The map will show them the location of those plants. In Mission 7, the students again explore the island, this time in search of some tiki statues. When they click on the statues, they're awarded points and a prize. In previous missions, they found the journal pages and constructed a map. In this mission, mission number 8, they need to use the map to find the mysterious energy-giving plants. When they find a plant, they can click on it to pick one of the leaves. They'll need these leaves for the next stage in the adventure. In mission number 9, they need to cooperate with their team members in order to combine the leaves and cook them down into an energy crystal. They have to use the journal page from Dr. Mo's journal that tells them the formula for the crystal. If they get the formula incorrect, there's a huge explosion. But if they get it correct, they're rewarded with a powerful energy crystal. They'll need this crystal for the next stage of the adventure. Now that they have an energy crystal, they'll need to get 5 more crystals in order to activate a teleporter. However, before they can do that, they'll have to fight off some zombies. Once the zombies are defeated, they need to exchange crystals with the other teams in order to get all 6 crystals. Once all 6 crystals are successfully put into the teleporter, they can now power it up and escape. Devil Island Mystery provides a story-driven, student-centered, immersive adventure for students of English. In order to complete the missions, students are challenged to use their English skills to successfully use the Second Life interface, to comprehend and follow video instructions.
When you find a plant, click on it. You'll get a leaf and 10 points,
as well as to communicate with their team members and record their experiences in their blogs. Devil Island Mystery provides an exciting, personalized community of practice where students use English in motivated, genuine, communicative situations. From creating and modifying their avatars, to working with team members, to completing complex story requirements, the students are constantly engaged in meaningful, task-based events that provide them with immediate and meaningful feedback. The various missions and tasks challenge their listening comprehension. You'll need to explore Devil Island to find the tiki statues. There are 10 of them in total. Reading comprehension, writing, and using in-world voice, speaking comprehension skills throughout the entire adventure. The adventure-based structure of the program promotes creative problem-solving, student-centered exploration, and unique, personalized learning experiences.